Okay. So, we are live. Hello everyone, can you hear me? Am I live? Yeah, should be live. Okay, we have already 58 people watching. That's awesome. Thanks for coming. So, I'm going to leave this video on my channel, so I'm going to do a quick introduction. So, hi everyone, welcome to another stream. Today I'm going to do a little unboxing. Like the title suggests, today we are going to look at Tatsuo Suzuki's new book. It's called Friction, Tokyo Streets. And to give you a little backstory, so I met Tatsuo in 2017. He came to Hamburg to do an exhibition for his Void Tokyo Collective. And at that time, I tried to reach out to him because I wanted to film an interview or a video for my channel. But I was too late and he didn't reply. But then I contacted the person who was organizing the exhibition, which is Damon Jha. Shout out to Damon if you're watching. And then he said, yeah, sure, come over. And I helped them, you know, film the exhibition and all that stuff. So that's how I met him. And at that time, he already, I think he won like a, what was it? You see, I'm not 100% prepared today because this is a spontaneous stream and I was out of my apartment. But the thing is, so he published his book with Steidl, which is like a huge photo book publisher in Germany. And I think he won the publishing of his book. I don't know exactly what competition it was, but he won first prize and then he got a book deal. And let me share my screen real quick. So this is his book on the Steidl website. And I think it launched yesterday. And thanks to Ulysses, I found out and immediately ordered. And yeah, let me just show you what Steidl did in the past. Like they did books for Bresson, Bruce Davidson, Robert Frank, Lee Friedlander, Nan Golden, Ernst Haas, Gary Winogrand, and much, much more, or many more. So for a photographer, getting a book deal with Steidl is a huge deal, so I'm very happy for him. And I don't know why it took so long, maybe they were waiting for the right time, but I know that they have been working on the book since 2017. I think it's the perfect time, because some of you guys know there was a little Fujifilm controversy going on in the beginning of this year, or was it last year? I think because of that, he gained a little bit more of, I don't know if we could say popularity, but he gained many new followers. And I think more people know him because of that. You could say bad publicity is good publicity, right? So let me see who's in the chat. Houdini is here, nice to see you. Mike Delvin is saying, I would like to know just how much of the work is actually Candid Street and how much is portraits done on the street. Yeah, we are going to opening up the package very soon and then we will have a look at it. And so he's doing Candid Street photography, but he also does portraits with models and they kind of look like street photography, but obviously they are staged or posed. But I think the title Friction is very interesting because we can talk about that a little bit more when once we open the book. Because the type of photos he does, I think he, as you can see, maybe if you haven't watched it, I will link all my videos I did with Tatsuo in the description. He's always looking for that connection with the subject. He wants to get some specific emotion, and the only way he can do that is by shooting the way he does. And I don't want to get into, you know, what's the right way to photograph. And you can look, there are many videos done about him because of the Fujifilm controversy. Timothy Zauter, I'm jealous how you get your copy so fast. Yeah, I mean, I'm in Germany, so I'm very spoiled because Steidl is in Germany and I guess for international shipping, it will take a little bit longer. It's also available on Amazon, but it looks like, because it's saying January 2021, which is a little bit too long. Yo, Camera Diaz is here. Dennis, moin. Good evening. Oh yeah, I made sure to stream at a Japan-friendly time. So maybe, I don't know, maybe Tatsu is watching or someone in Japan is probably appreciating the timing. Where's Alex? He was in the chat very early. I can't see him. Okay, I think we should just start because it will be boring for people re-watching this stream. Yeah, as you can see, I haven't opened it up yet. And I couldn't prepare a second camera angle, so I will make sure to do some close-ups with the camera I got. It's also crazy how fast the book sold out, or how many times it sold out. People were commenting on his Instagram, it's already sold out. And then they restocked it. So, make sure to see the chat. Open it already. Okay, I'm doing it. Good evening, watching from Philippines. How much is the book in peso? Don't ask me that. I have no idea, but I think Google will help you. And I think shipping internationally is free. So free shipping, schneller. Okay, zeig Smurf. So here we have it. Nicely wrapped. Guess we can get rid of that. Oh, you already have the book, Paolo. Awesome. That's fast. You're not in Germany. That's crazy that you already got it. Okay, let's do the reveal in close-up style. I will slowly bring it in focus. Oh, wait. It's saying my address. That was close. Let's get this. Oh, it's the delivery paper. Yeah, I have no autofocus on this lens. Okay. Ta-da. It's still wrapped, so you can see. Oh, it's pretty big. That's the back. Yeah, let's open it up. I'm probably totally out of focus, but that's okay. I already like how it feels. Tatsu used to have an X100F. I don't know if he currently uses it. It's still, yeah, no idea either. I haven't talked to him since the Fujifilm incident. We've only been in contact through Instagram. So, ta-da, I will go closer. Friction Tokyo Street. Oh, I thought it was Tokyo Streets. I need to correct my title. So yeah, and I don't know if you can see it in the stream, but it has some very nice texture. It's a pretty thick book. I don't know how many pages, but it looks like, I don't know, a lot. Okay. Yeah, it's not like super hard. You can see it's, but it's also not soft. It's nice. Okay, how should we do that? Should I just go through them like page per page? So the first page is just black. And this design was kind of expected. Like he shoots black and white mainly. Very contrast photos. I like that it starts with just black. Shit, I wish I had a tabletop camera that can shoot down. Moin moin, hab's mir heute Morgen direkt bestellt. Nice, du Freizeitknipser. Ja. Oh, there are actually two pages, blank pages. You know what? I'm going to tilt my camera down so you can see better. Hopefully it's not too messy. Okay, I will do it like so maybe. Okay. Man, it's really hard to do this. Maybe just like this. And for some photos, I will do a close-up. So, the title photo. This is definitely, of course, a portrait. And I think he told me at his exhibition that he shot... This was his first... I think it was his first try. Like, he used the flash through an transparent umbrella. And then the first one was this, and then he kept going for, I don't know how many shots, but he said he was doing it for, I don't know, 20 minutes or so. Don't quote me on that though. And then the first one was this. So. Wow. Wait, before we go on, we have to comment on the paper here. If I would have to describe the paper quality, I would describe it as, if you see his photos, just imagine how the best possible feeling for his photos. I don't know. I think the feeling of the paper fits his style. I should have researched what material and paper they used. Yeah, I'm very sorry, guys, that I have to improvise here. Maybe we can just hold it here and then do this. So. Damn it. Yeah, it's crazy that this is his first book, because you would imagine he already published a book, but this is actually his very first photo book. I love this photo. I have a print, actually, of this one. So I think these photos are from... I think they're already 10 years old, some of them. This is actually, I think, an old photo of his. And this one, I have a print of this photo, too. I was able to grab a few prints from his exhibition. I will try to go through all of it. And maybe we can stop for a few photos. I'm actually looking at it through my through OBS, through my computer. So I can't really enjoy the paper quality and the sharpness. But let me actually check. Oh, sorry. Oh yeah, that's really nice. It's a super matte paper. As you can see, there's not much reflecting. But the blacks are still very deep. They don't feel like 100% black. But it's a nice deep black. Who's the artist? Is Angry Gold Star asking. this is Tatsuo Suzuki's first photo book, Japanese street photographer. Founder of Voi Tokyo Collective. I don't know these ones. Yeah. He also used to shoot homeless people a lot. I think he hung out with them, and he was doing that for a while. I also love this this one. And this is a good spread here to talk a little bit about his approach, because when you, if you remember the Fujifilm promo video, you saw how he takes photos. He's like using his camera almost like a video camera. It's like holding it and then going in front of people, and he's always crossing the path of people, and sometimes he interrupts also people walking, and it does look very aggressive, especially for a Japanese person. That's a big no-no. You can't make other people uncomfortable. But the thing is, he, in this promo video from Fujifilm, it was translated on the original Fujifilm video, but not with the re-uploads. He was saying that he when he started out, he wasn't happy with his photos, like something was lacking. And then he experimented with different ways of taking photos. And at the end, this is what worked for him. Like, and only this way of shooting gets him the photos he was looking for. Yeah, this is definitely a portrait. So not candid. So his style comes off like very aggressive, but I think what I can respect about him is that he goes like 100% all the way. He doesn't compromise, you know. He wants to take a photo and he just does it. And in person, when you meet him, and he is like a super considerable, or how do you say, respectful guy, like very almost shy when you talk to him. So it's kind of weird to see these photos, and then you expect a photographer who, you know, who would be like a super asshole in person, but he actually does care a lot about the people he photographs. This is a scene you often see in Shibuya or in Tokyo. I think these are all like street portraits, but not staged. I mean, they are not like portraits of models. Crazy, this one. How many photographs and hours he put into this book? I have no idea. I think he came to Germany to work on that with Steidl. And I think the publisher did a lot of the sequencing, and I'm not 100% sure how much he was involved. It looks very dark, but I can't raise my the brightness here. Sorry guys, maybe I can. Oh yeah, ISO. What's the irony of talking about the Fujifilm promo video, and I have a Fujifilm promo booklet here, which I'm using as my mouse pad. hi Samuel, is there a picture of this book that you saw him taking when you met him? Or you mean if there's a photo in the book? Maybe. I mean, if we can see photos of Hamburg in this book, then no, that's not true, because the photos, the good photos he took in Hamburg, he shot them when I was not with him. But could be, yeah, could be. Crazy. This is definitely a portrait. This looks like candid. Yo, Wolfgang ist hier. But for a manufacturer, is this type of photography difficult? For a manufacturer, this type... Oh, you mean, yeah, for a camera manufacturer or company. Yeah, this type of photography is not advertisement friendly, right? But I think they should have known what they're getting themselves into. And the thing is, before that promo video, everyone was okay with his photos. And they were okay with his photos, but not until they saw how he takes them. Oops. Okay, we are halfway through, so this was just half of the book. Oh, it's getting hard to turn the page. Sorry, I need to do this. Wow. No idea what's happening here, but they look intense. Yeah, these are some of the portraits of homeless people in Tokyo he did. There are actually a lot of homeless people in Tokyo, but you won't see them on the street because they have their own park. Aloy is saying it was his identity, and to drop him when he started getting flagged for it is unprofessional. Yeah, I still have a little bit of sympathy with Fujifilm. I can totally understand their move. I mean, they were just saving, you know, their reputation, which is a little bit of a shame because they kind of threw Tatsuo under the bus. But at the end, I think it actually helped him a little bit, you know, getting his work seen by many people. Yo, Sean is here. What's up? Wow, man, beautiful stuff. Very dramatic. Yeah, it's very dramatic. This is definitely a portrait. It's a shame because I have a very long video of him explaining photos from the exhibition, and this was one of them. And I just need to translate them, but I'm not so good in Japanese that I can do it without any help. So once I can convince my wife to help me translate it, yeah, I could maybe publish that video. This is very nice. I like this. Oh, it's very hard to turn pages. Where can you buy prints from him online? I think from his website, but I'm not sure if he sells prints. He has a zine. He does like a monthly zine, I think. Yeah, definitely check out his website. I'm not 100% sure. Oh. Looks slightly blue, like when I printed negatives. The blue cast could be because of my white balance. It's a little bit under daylight temperature, so let me check. It's definitely, there's definitely no blue cast in real life. So it's just black and white. This is very cool. So I think we have 20 or more pages. And I think he shot on the GR before he was shooting on the X100. But I'm not sure which photos were shot on the GR. This is also nice. He shot a photo that looked almost exactly like this in Hamburg. This would be a typical Hamburg scene. But looks, oh, to go back to that one question about photos from Hamburg, I think this is only Tokyo because it's called Tokyo Street. I can relate to that person. Yeah, exactly. Snap photography is a very Japanese style. I suppose Daido Maruyama is in the same vein. Yeah, interesting. Do you know why it developed there? Is it something about the culture? That is a... Yeah, snap photography is... So the Japanese people, they don't say street photography. For them, street photography is part of snap photography. So snapshot photography is very loose, casual. Not so serious maybe, but or very raw. It's hard to, there's one Japanese word that describes, like I translated it in the video I did with him as rawness, but sometimes, you know, there are words that you can't translate in another language. Yeah, but like I didn't really talk to Japanese photographers about that, but whenever they talk about, you know, what they're looking for, it, to me, it feels like, because Japan is such a reserved country, everyone is, you know, standing in line and making sure they're not making other people uncomfortable, and no one is really, okay, that's the end. I think photographers like him, or maybe Daido Moriyama as well, I mean, what's it called again? The magazine or the collective from Daido Moriyama. Shit, I forgot it. I have a brain fog right now. I think because people in Japan are very emotionless, so that's what I experience when I shoot pictures in Tokyo. If you want to take photos of people, everyone is smiling, happy. There's just happiness around you. But you don't see scenes like this very often. And I think photographers in Japan, they want more than just what's on the outside. You know, they want to see what people feel on the inside, or maybe show the vulnerability of people. I mean, I'm just talking for them right now, so it could be a different motivation, but yeah, I think the more you shoot in Japan, the more you want more than just smiley faces. Okay, let me fix my camera. So, yeah, this was just a quick view of his first book. Yeah, if you want to check it out, links in the description. I'm not affiliated to Steidl or Tatsu, also didn't ask me to do this. I just want to support him, so check out his book if you want. I think it's still available, but it seems to be running out of stock a lot. Yes, Provoke magazine. Thank you, Mitch. Yeah, the whole Provoke era, I think, came exactly out of this frustration. You know, they wanted to do something more, how do you say, like, yeah, raw. It's very hard to translate that one word. Now it's called namanamashi in Japanese, I think. Do you know anything about his workflow? You mean in terms of taking pictures or printing, or I mean, all you need to know, you can see how he shoots on my on the street video. It's also linked under this video. I think he shoots what's it called when you like he's definitely closing the aperture like to 11 or 16 because he wants everything in focus. And I mean, you can just see it in the videos. He's using the LCD and he's kind of like filming. It's like he's shooting video. Most people would probably stop and take photos, but he's like very free flowing. It's very funny seeing him on the street. Yeah. Let me see if I missed any good questions. How will snap photography evolve within this new reality following COVID-19? Good question. Could be a whole live stream topic. I don't know, man. I don't know. I think snap photography will always be what snap photography is, regardless of the circumstances. But in terms of candid street photography, we have to see. Yeah, Paul is saying you should interview him and discuss his book and the pictures he took. Yeah, I thought about inviting him to the stream, but I decided it today, so it was a bit on a short notice. We would have to do it in Japanese, and I would have to try to translate it. And I don't know if you want to do that. I don't think he's someone who wants to be on streams and give interviews. He's a very reserved person. What neck strap do you use? This is my my mother-in-law made it. I'm working on producing these, so stay tuned for that. But I'm hoping to do this summer. I don't want to make this stream too long, but we are done with the important part. Let me see, Christian is here. From what I know, it is because of the evolution of the atomic bomb. Oh yeah, after the atomic bomb and how photography could be done. Yeah. Why is it published by a German publisher? He won this book deal. I forgot what the actual competition was or contest. Let me share this with you again here. So Steidl is the publisher. And this is the best thing that could happen to him, because having a book published by them is like, that's the goal. Sorry, I missed out on a lot of questions during the presentation. Yeah, maybe we can do a stream one day, if he is up to it. Okay. Let me see if I missed any cool details. I haven't really checked what's at the end. Oh yeah, it was. It's called the Steidl Book Awards, and he won that. He is the Steidl Book Award winner from Japan. So maybe they published other books too, from other people. So it's saying here. Artists throughout Japan were invited to submit their book dummies for consideration for the Steidl Book Award Japan. 700 dummies were received, each of which Gerhard Steidl personally reviewed before choosing the 8 winners. So that means he probably created a dummy book, and then they decided to do his book. Yeah. Okay, that is it. Tokyo Street, no, Friction, Tokyo Street, Tatsuo Suzuki. Congratulations, Tatsuo. Although you're probably not watching right now, but maybe you're rewatching it later. Yeah, thanks for hanging out, and check out the description if you want to get one. And yeah, I think I will do another stream soonish. I have no other news, sorry. Tomorrow there will be a small video coming out, but it's not newsworthy. It's a short video. He should do a Ricoh 3 street camera video. It would be great for showing his technique. I don't think Ricoh would risk that. Okay, cool. So thank you again. Have a good rest of the week, good weekend, wherever you are. Stay safe, stay clean, and I see you in another video or stream.